morning, children. Welcome to the session. We are discussing English subject. Our third lesson is in the gift of the Magi, standard, 10th standard. This is the fifth session we are discussing. Four sessions we have discussed regarding this lesson. It is 23 paragraphs over, where we stopped in the last class. That is, Della is waiting for her husband after cooking. That is at 7 o'clock. She made coffee and also cooked the food. So let's see what happens in the 24th paragraph onwards. So 24th paragraph. Jim was never late. Della doubled the fork chain in her hand and sat on the corner of the table near the door that he always entered. Then she heard his step on the stair away down on the first flight, and she turned white for just a moment. She had a habit of saying a little silent prayer about the simplest everyday things. And now she whispered, "Please God, make him think I am still pretty." So, after waiting for Jim to return, she heard the sound of the Jim that is coming up to the room. That is, from the sound of his step, she heard his step on the stair. And in the same way, in the meantime, she is also going to praying to God that let her husband, that is Jim, not be angry with her because of selling her hairs. And as usual, that she expected from her husband. So, 25th paragraph, I think you understood that lines what I read. 25th paragraph, the door opened and the Jim stepped in and closed it. He looked thin and very serious. Poor fellow, he was only 22 and to be burdened with the family. He needed a new overcoat and he was without gloves. So here the description, simple description of the Jim was made. That is, after 22 years of age, Jim was only 22 years of age. 22 years of age, and he was very thin. He was a very thin and a very serious looking man. He was a thin and a very serious looking man. Very serious looking man. That the expression was given when he returned to the home. He was a poor fellow. Okay, so he needed a new overcoat and he was without gloves. Without gloves, he is having a overcoat, the new overcoat. So Jim stopped inside the door, as immovable as a setter at the scent of quail. So after entering into the room, that is, he stood there only for a moment, as immovable, said, remain motionless. So here, setter means remain motionless. When he entered the house, his room, looking at the Della wife, he stood there only for a moment as a setter. That is, immovable. As I said, remain motionless for a few minutes at the scent of quail. His eyes were fixed upon Della, and there was an expression in them that she could not read, and it terrified her. So, where Della was afraid of her husband, whether he was not happy with that what she did. And when she saw her husband's face, that is a mixture, that is a not predictable one, that is a, yes sir, there was an expression in them that she could not read. She can't understand the feelings expression that Jim showed on that particular day when he returned, and that looks in a manner of affright the Della. It terrified her. It was not anger, nor surprise, nor disapproval, nor horror, nor any of the sentiments that she had been prepared for. Was she mentally prepared herself? Apart from that, a different expression was noticed in Jim, and that was terrified, it was terrifying to her. He simply stared at her fixedly. He simply stared at her fixedly with that peculiar expression on his face. Della wriggled off the table and went for him. And she put Della wriggled off. So she diverted the mind and expression of the husband and said, "Jim, darling," she cried, "don't look at me that way. I had my hair cut off and sold because I could not have lived through Christmas without giving you a present." So she understood the situation, and not even spending more time, she said to the husband, "Jim, darling, don't look at that way." That is, she confessed that she has sold her hair and bought a gift for him, and also she said that she cannot live without a gift in that particular Christmas day. "It will grow out again, you won't mind." So never mind of this what she has done. She is requesting, pleasing, "Will you? I just had to do it. So my hair grows awfully fast." Never mind, my hair will grow fast like that. She was going to be compromising the husband, okay. "Say Merry Christmas, Jim. Let's be happy. You don't know what a beautiful, nice gift I have got for you," she said like that. So she is going to convincing the husband that her hair will grow faster, and she bought a nice beautiful gift for him. "You have cut off your hair?" asked Jim laboriously, as if he had not arrived at that patent fact yet, even after the hardest mental labor. Even the sentence says that he might not observe that hair, and he said that, "Have you cut off your hairs?" "Cut it off and sold it," said Della. "Don't you like me just as well, anyhow? I am me without my hair. I am not I. That is, she is questioning, that is, whether you are going to like or not like in that small hair, without long hair. And she is saying that, "I am the same wife," that is Della, "without any long hairs. So don't you like me?" Like that she questioned the husband. Jim looked about the room curiously. She never replied, never answered that question. "You say your hair is gone," he said, with an air almost of idiocy. "You did not look for it," said Della. "It's sold, I tell you. Sold and gone too. It's a Christmas Eve. Bye. Be good to me, for it went for you." She is just convincing her husband Don't think of that lost hairs. It will grow up and it's for your sake only, for taking a gift. I did this one like that. She is going to convincing the husband, saying that I have bought a gift for you for a Christmas you. Maybe the hairs of my head were numbered. She went on with sudden serious sweetness, but nobody could ever count my love for you. Shall I put the chops on Jim? By saying like that, she said, whether I put food for you, like that she went up, saying that, shall I make you the chops ready? Out of his trance, Jim seemed quickly to wake. He unfolded his Della. So, he never worried and angry upon the dearest, lovable wife. She unfolded his Della. For 10 seconds, let us regard with discreet scrutiny some inconsequential object in the other direction. $8 a week or a year, what is the difference? Here, the sentence why we say that is, they are not worried about the wealth because they are very, very lovable with each other and very lovable couple pair they are. And even though they are not having enough money, the love with each other they are having, that is a great water. The line says, a mathematician or a wit could give you the wrong answer. The Magi bought valuable gifts, but that was not among them. This dark assertion will be illuminated later on. Jim drew a package from his overcoat pocket and threw it upon the table. So, by hugging the wife, he also opened a packet, that is from his package, from his overcoat pocket, and threw it on the table. That is, here also, the clue that he has also bought some gift from the stores for her. So that, what is the gift that Jim bought to her, that we will discuss in the next session. Okay, in this session we are able to understand that how Della is going to convincing the husband after he was returned to the home from office. And what is the expression that she has noticed on her husband, and how Jim reacted to the Della, and how finally he is convinced and hugged the wife, that is we learned in this paragraph. The next period, let we learn what is the package that Jim has put on the table, that we are going to learn in the next period. Okay children, take care. In the next period we will learn the remaining paragraph. Take care, bye.